Dave here from Llamachant Technology. Interacting with controls in your XAF application is essential to customizing the user experience. In this application, I want to remove the spin edit buttons from any numeric property editor if it's non-editable. For example, when the use custom rate checkbox is toggled, the custom rate value editor changes between editable and non-editable. When non-editable, the spin edit, or value up and down buttons, should not be visible. To make this more interesting, I want the same functionality in both my Blazor XAF application and my WinXAF application. To make this happen, I'm going to create a controller that targets any detail view. And because I want this functionality to be the same in both my Blazor application and WinXAF application, I'm going to add the controller to the .module project, which is platform agnostic. So in my controllers folder within the .module project, I'm adding a property editor customization controller. We're going to scope this controller down to any detail view. I'm going to create a list of property editors that I populate in the onActivated override by calling the view.getItems method. For each editor, we're going to subscribe to the control created and the allow edit changed events. Of course, anytime we subscribe to events of shared objects, it's a good idea to unsubscribe from them in the onDeactivated override. This allows the .NET garbage collection to do its work more efficiently. With that out of the way, we're going to add a new virtual method to update the property editors when the control is created or the ability to edit changes. We are making this method virtual because we can't really do anything with platform-specific controls in the platform-agnostic module. It's important to note that you should not reference any Blazor or Win controls in the module project directly. You've been warned, don't do it. We're going to run this project and see that each property editor in our created detail view is hitting the update property editors method as we would expect. Now we're going to make this controller work for the editors in each platform. To do this, we add a new controller in the Blazor project that inherits from the controller we created in the .module. In this controller, we just have to override the update property editor method and do whatever platform-specific work we want. With the Blazor numeric property editor, we can get the component model and set the show spin buttons property to true or false. We will now repeat this process for our WinForms project. In this case, we're working directly with the spin edit control and affecting the button visibility. With both of these platform-specific controllers in place, we can run the applications and see our customizations take effect. Based on our implementation of these controllers, we can easily modify the default behavior of any property editors moving forward without having to create a new controller.